clock rung. Mama woke her out the bed. She's getting dressed for school, putting barrettes in her hair. An honor roll student, real smart is what they said. Every morning when she left, mom would cook her grits and eggs. Pops worked two jobs to bring in the bread. Mama stayed in the kitchen and kept the welfare. Now here she go, went to meet her friends at the bus stop on the avenue. That's when the old Cadillac dropped. The man that was driving snatched her up around 8 o'clock while her friends and the bus driver waiting down the block. No one heard her scream. He turned the bass up a notch. She was tampered with, second floor in an abandoned spot. No telephone to burn, so she couldn't call the cops. He threw her in the bathroom, made sure the door was locked. All she was thinking, why me and will it stop? All she was thinking, why me and will it stop? It's a damn shame. She thinks she's skipping school, but only if they knew what was really going on. She's crying for y'all help while y'all talking on the phone. The teacher's on the wrong subject, saying that she thinks she grown. Somebody call the police. Damn, calling up Tyrone. So her mother filed a report on her own. This is the description that she gave what was known. 15, she was last seen standing on the cone eating ice cream at the bus stop on 10th Street in Lindley Ave, just a few feet from the spot where she stayed. Pink mini skirt and French braids, 110 pounds. What she weighed? 5'2", eyes blue, gray, blue, gray. She's trying to pick the lock, so we threw her in his lap, riding with the doors locked. Drove her through the woods that was right around the block. Dropped her off at the hospital in the parking lot. The school bell rung for the end of a class. At the same time, she was running in the flash to go and call her mother, but her mother isn't there. And when she finally seen her, speculation filled the air. Her mama don't believe her. She keeps calling the tricks and whores, saying, I told you about them older men before. Her father didn't need her, afraid to face the sticks and stones. And now she's searching for the grace to carry on. It's a
damn shame that someone